Before starting this course on career counseling, it is extremely important to understand why you should take your career choice seriously. In this video, we will help you understand the importance of making the right career choice for yourself. So, why is your career choice so important? It is important because it determines a lot of things in your life, including number 1. Quality of life. Your career choice plays a huge role in deciding where you live, how flexible your life is, and the kinds of things you are able to do in your free time. Number 2. Identity. Ask any elder person about their career and they will tell you about it as a part of their identity. They'll say something like, "I am a journalist," instead of, "I report news." Notice how everybody asks you, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" and not, "What do you want to do when you grow up?" This shows that your career choice shapes your identity. Number 3. Impact. Every human life touches thousands of other lives in so many different ways. If you select any 60-year-old person who is about to retire, take a time machine, find him as an infant, throw that infant into trash, and then come back to the present day, you'll find that a countless number of things around you have changed. So whatever career you choose, the world will be affected by it. Anything that determines your quality of life, your identity, and the impact that you make should be taken very seriously. And that includes your career choice also. So we hope that this short video could help you understand the importance of making the right career choice. Having done that, we will now move forward to start our career counseling course. We are pretty excited and we hope you are too. So, let's begin. See you. Hello, hi, good evening everyone, and welcome to the day 72, I guess, of Probanos Daily Life Career Guidance Podcast. आज हमारे साथ सामंत तो नहीं है, लेकिन the better host is here, so you don't worry. और आज दोस्तों हम बात करेंगे, today topic is very relevant one, in the current times especially. And the topic for today is tackling a crisis, which is Amphan. Or as they genuinely pronounce it, Umphan, which is what I just read up on Google. Now, has been a very devastating cyclone and a very challenging one for Bengal. And uske jo uske effect rahe hai, wo bahut hi adverse rahe hai. Aur abhi Bengal usse ubhar raha hai, which is our own state. And I belong to that state. But usse ubharne mein bahut sare efforts are going a long way in helping out. And today we have with us my college mates, my friends, my batchmate and my juniors, jinhone bahut hi acche efforts dale hain with a student outreach initiative called Ichhe, which I was minorly a part of during the last year of my college days. Aur bahut acha lagta hai dekh ke ki they have done such great efforts and they have already completed phase 1 of their donation drive and contribution towards the children that we taught and children we are teaching. और उसी के साथ साथ अभी फेज 2 की शुरुआत हुई है टुवर्ड्स द डोनेशन ड्राइव एंड दिस इज व्हाई वी आर कंडक्टिंग दिस एक्सट्रीमली स्पेशल स्ट्रीम एंड एट प्रोबनो ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ प्रोबनो वी कंसिडर आवरसेल्व्स एक्सट्रीमली लकी कि हम इस डोनेशन ड्राइव का छोटा सा हिस्सा बन पा रहे हैं. सो फ्रेंड्स, फॉर द नेक्स्ट 3-4 डेज वी विल बी रेजिंग डोनेशंस फॉर द सेकंड फेज ऑफ दिस इनिशिएटिव एंड हूएवर वांट्स टू डोनेट वी विल क्विकली शेयर द डिटेल्स विद यू इन द कमेंट सेक्शन एंड वी विल आल्सो शेयर आवर स्क्रीन्स. But before that, I really want to talk to the people who have been a part of this initiative, a very active part, and the people who have really helped the students and their families in the journey of recovery from this devastating cyclone. So I want to welcome Pankaj, Maitri, and Adarsh, my college mates and my juniors, to this podcast. And I really want to start off with Pankaj, who was my batchmate in the very same branch. Both of us are from IT. मैं पंकज से शुरुआत करना चाहता हूँ और मैं पंकज से पूछना चाहता हूँ कि वो अपना एक छोटा सा इंट्रोडक्शन दे एंड टू फॉर हिम टू एड्रेस द ऑडियंस. वेलकम पंकज, थैंक यू फॉर ग्रेसिंग द पॉडकास्ट विद योर प्रेजेंस एंड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू योर इंट्रोडक्शन. यू म्यूटेड पंकज.
Hey, I'm so sorry. Yeah. Hi, everyone. Hi, this is Pankaj, and thanks, Aditya, for calling me to this podcast. We and Aditya were batchmate in IIST Shippur, and currently I am working in as a software engineer in Qualcomm. So, giving a brief introduction of Itche, how it started, like. So it all started in the year 2014 with the aim of to provide a basic education to underprivileged children who are not like privileged enough to get the basic education in our free time. So we strongly believe we students have a lot of time, spare time, which we can utilize to do a bit of part from our side to the towards society. So with that aim, we have started, and going on, we'll discuss what is currently we are doing and what is our aim with today's podcast. So thanks, Aditya, again for giving us this opportunity. Yeah.
थैंक यू सो मच पंकज. जनरली दोस्तों जब हम हीरोज को इमेजिन करते हैं तो हम इमेजिन करते हैं कि उन्होंने केप्स पहने होंगे और वो कुछ सुपरमैन टाइप की कॉस्ट्यूम होगी, कुछ बड़े बड़े डोले शोले होंगे. लेकिन आई थिंक जो भी हमारे साथ ऐसे काम कर रहे हैं, हमारे साथ मौजूद है, हमारे दोस्त जो ऐसे काम कर रहे हैं एंड दे आर डूइंग सच अ बिग कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू द सोसाइटी, आई थिंक दे आर ऑल्सो हीरोज इन देयर वेरी ओन राइट. एंड आई स्टिल रिमेंबर द यू नो वन ऑफ द अर्लियर पॉडकास्ट व्हेन डॉक्टर स्मितेश वॉज द गेस्ट. He said one thing which stuck with me. I repeated in the last podcast also, which was ki there are ordinary people who have extraordinary stories. And I think this is one such extraordinary story, ki how a student initiative from the college has gone on to be recognized by the cabinet minister for education and human resource development, and how, you know, it has gone on such a long way. So want to introduce Maitri with this, who is still very actively working with the student initiative. So Maitri, would really love if you can introduce yourself and address the audience.
Thank you for hosting me here. First of all, I'm Maitri, way between a fourth year undergraduate and undergraduate, because I don't know what I am now, but yeah, I am a fourth year computer science student from IIST Shippur, and I've been in ITCHE from my very first month of my college life, and it has been a great experience for me, and hoping to share all my experiences with you in this podcast. And thank you for having me here.
Great. Thank you so much, Maitri, for gracing the podcast with your presence. And now I would like to pass on the ball to Adarsh. Adarsh, I think, is still a student of IIST Shippur. Yeah. So would really love to hear from him. And I'm pretty sure that he has been one of the most active in the student initiative. So Adarsh, would love to hear your introduction and your addressing the audience.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for me having here. And currently I am the second year student. Moreover, you can say that in third year, because our exams have been cancelled and that's all. It has been a very great experience for me to be a part of such a team and to do something that can help our society, And thanks, I will share my experience.
Thank you so much, Adarsh. And we will like to start with, or ye hum karte rahenge during the podcast. So Pragya, if you can just share the pic and let me know, so I can, let you know the details, everyone who is in the audience watching and everyone who will watch later, ki aap kaise is cause ko donate kar sakte hai aur ye cause hai kya? And I think one of our amazing team members from ITCHE can describe the cause also. So Pragya, can you share the pic, please? The pic is on? Sure. So just let us know when it is on and we'll quickly let people know. It's on? Great. So would really I like one of you if you can just describe कि इस डोनेशन ड्राइव में इच्छे क्या कर रहा है और किन-किन चीजों को हम यू नो बाय कर रहे हैं और उसके लिए कितना अमाउंट चाहिए और वो लोग कैसे डोनेट कर सकते हैं. सो द पिक इज ऑन द स्क्रीन गाइस. सो पंकज इफ यू कैन टेक द बॉल एंड लेट पीपल नो.
म्यूटेड
पंकज यू म्यूटेड. मैत्री मैत्री इफ यू कैन लेट अस नो ये जो स्टूडेंट इनिशिएटिव. श्योर. या
Hello. Yes. Hey
yeah,
again.
We can hear you.
Yeah. I guess Matt is the right person to share because he is carrying everything like from the day one. I remember. So Matt, can you please share everything like all the data, whatever you have? We can add on like, okay. Further going. Yeah.
Okay. So how we started it was after Amphan. Even I was affected. I had seen my area. So we started calling up our Ichhe kids to let know what the situation is. Are they getting food? Do they have electricity? Do they have water? So initially we were doing a small survey of just Ichhe kids and their families. So we collected data. 7 families and most of them had food scarcity problems. Very few of them were getting ration because they are basically migrant laborers from states like UP and Jharkhand. So they don't have local ration cards as well. So in our first phase, we just took donation from our student community, our contacts. And in our first phase, we managed to distribute 1,000 rupees each to each of these 37 families for their ration. But then we thought that we shouldn't discriminate on just the basis of Ichhe. There are many more families in that area who are still affected and we should reach out to them too. But providing 1,000 rupees each to each family was difficult because as students, raising such a big amount of money is difficult. So we did a survey of around 250 people with the help of one of our Ichhe students. And we again found out that food scarcity was a major issue. Yes, there are damages in structures, in buildings, some broken houses, but food is the necessity for survival. If you have food, you can manage buildings. So we thought, okay, we can't give 1,000 rupees each. Let us provide ration to people. If we can maybe give 500 rupees ration to each of the people, each of the families, maybe they'll have food for a week or so. So we started our second round of collection of funds and we had got great response initially, but then somehow the funds slowed down. And since last 2 days, we are not getting any funds. We had a meeting today about how to go further and we are short of funds. We are deficit of funds. We were thinking of raising, and if we could raise 97,000 something, we could have given around 500 rupees food package to around 226 families, less than 500 rupees food package because we would be going to wholesalers. But then we were having a deficit of around 10,000 rupees. So that's the main thing that I told Aditya Bhaiya, that Bhaiya, we are facing problems and if you could help us, because if we delay, let's say for 4 or 5 days, that wouldn't be a problem for us. But those who are not having food, they are, for them, 1 day is a year. So then Aditya Bhaiya is very helpful. So he's helping us to reach that amount. Pankaj Bhaiya, Adarsh, if you want to add anything.
Like Matri said, like till now we have been able to provide a relief of rupees 1,000 to 37 families, right, Matri?
Yes, Bhaiya. Yeah.
So 37 families. Initially, like we thought of serving only Ichhe people, but later we found like as a society, we shouldn't be discriminating. So yeah, we have served around 300. Families till now, 200 to 300. Yeah, we are holding the service as of now. But it all depends on like fund collection, like whether we can go further to add more families in that area or not. Because as per our knowledge, there are still like 500 to 600 families living there. So it's not about only 10K we are running short of. It is like to serve that 226 family, we are running short of 10k right now. So yeah, if you could manage to get more fund, we can continue this approach or this way of this donation thing to more families to that area, and maybe we can extend the area. So yeah.
Thank you so much, guys, for sharing details and the efforts that you have put in. And I think Maitri mentioned that we are helpful. I think you guys are actually helpful to the people who really need it. And I think all of us should definitely contribute to this cause in whatever small capacity we have. So, dosto, friends, everyone, we have the details on the screen. You will be seeing two mobile numbers and two bank details also. So, please do donate as much as possible. And you must be seeing, you know, different methods of payment. So, bank details are given, account number and IFSC code. The UPI ID of Deependra Pushkar and Asif Iftikhar are given. So guys, everything is very well accounted for. These are students of IIST Shippur only who are very actively involved in this initiative and are doing a lot of groundwork. And I have been there in the same college. I have worked with these guys. Amazing guys, are very helpful towards the society and have contributed a lot to the development of these students educationally first. And now obviously they are contributing to their families as well. तो दोस्तों जितना भी आपके आपसे हो सके डू डेफिनेटली डोनेट अगर अब तक हमारे 71 डेज ऑफ पॉडकास्ट आई थिंक वी हैव डन बिफोर दिस इफ इट हैज टॉट यू एनीथिंग इफ इट हैज हेल्प यू इन एनी मैनर पॉसिबल सो डू डेफिनेटली डोनेट आई थिंक इट विल बी अ ग्रेट विन फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस एज अ सोसाइटी नॉट जस्ट अस और इच्छे और दोस विक्टिम्स बट आई थिंक फॉर एवरी वन बिकॉज दिस शोज एम्पैथी एंड दिस शोज दैट वी आर कमिंग टुगेदर एज अ ह्यूमन रेस व्हिच वाज मिसिंग अ लॉट बिफोर दिस क्राइसिस. And now I want to address Mr. Sain. So Pragya, now you can probably take the photo of the screen for a while and we can talk a bit. Then we'll again probably show the bank details after a while.
Thank you, Aditya. Good evening. Right. Namaskar. Welcome to the show, all of you. And it's a fantastic story that you guys are working on. And could you kindly tell us which area you're working on? Is it around Shippur, West Bengal, or is it slightly outside that? So, Maitri, maybe you can.
So, sir, this area is just outside our college. Our college is situated in Shippur. So, this area is actually a part of Foreshore Road that is along the banks of Ganga. And that's between Ganga and our borders of IIST Shippur, that is in Shippur, that comes in Howrah.
Yeah, and Howrah is one of the most affected areas.
Sir, as we all know that every one of us has been affected by Umphun, but Ganga has the banks of Ganga are more affected because the levels of Ganga had increased. So there was water everywhere. There was water and obviously tree fell. And their homes are not the concrete homes that we are used to seeing every day. Their homes are mostly made up of wood, the spare materials that they get, asbestos, tin, some flex, if they can get flex. They also have flex walls or flex ceilings. So these materials are very easy to be blown away or to be destroyed. So that is one thing. The second thing is that most of the workers there are either rickshaw walas or vegetable sellers or some kind of contractual workers that they do on a regular basis. They don't have this foreseeing that if there is a condition, we'll do savings for that. They earn daily, they spend daily. So for them, a situation like this is very difficult because they have lost their jobs and they didn't have any savings. So these are the two main problems that are there in that area, Mr. Sen.
And with COVID, because this is on the back of COVID, and COVID was there already for over 60 days when Umphan came and hit. So yes, in COVID, they also did not get any earnings to that extent. So it was compounded. So how what is the situation? What is the state of the people over there? And what have you all, or what has people done to provide them with shelter? Because food is one part, you talked about it, but there is also shelter, there is also medical needs, because people need medical, especially after a cyclone. There is, and you have COVID as well. So can you please say a few words on that, if you have?
Mr. Singh, after the COVID, those 60 days, we were constantly in touch with the kids, but they didn't specify of a huge hunger problem then. But what I learned from them is that there were some political parties, local political parties, who were distributing food then, raw food. There was also an NGO there when which used to cook food and give it for once a day to all the families. So we unfortunately were not a part of those sacrifices then. But if you come to the after Umphun, we realized, we surveyed about the medicines. There are medical problems there. There are people with diabetes, and mostly they have knee pain, kind of pain issues. There are people, one of our kid fell ill some days back. So what we don't have those much funds. So what we were thinking is, we at Itche had also organized a medical camp a few years back, a year or two back, where these families were checked up, and there was a organization, I don't remember the name, I'm sorry, but they had provided free medicines to all these families. So our professor, Subhashish Banerjee sir, he has talked to those organizations, and when our distribution is on, we'll try to approach them for medicines. And the third question, Mr. Sen, I forgot.
Shelter.
So, Mr. Sen, because shelter costs a lot, because even if we have to provide maybe rods or asbestos or I'm not recognizing the name. But so what we were planning is that we'll form a team of those people. They'll have some spare parts. Maybe someone will have some spare wood. Someone will have some spare rod, some spare asbestos, some spare tin. And we'll form a team of those local people. And we'll try to tell them, convince them to form a team and then help the others. Because, Mr. Sen, we again are saying that shelter costs a lot. And we really don't have food to provide for both shelter and food. So that was our plan, that once we haven't been able to visit the place till now because of the lockdown compounded with COVID and roads being blocked and everything. So our student was serving that area. So we have this plan that once we go to the place that will be on the distribution day, we'll survey that area, and then again, if we have funds, then maybe we'll think of helping them monetarily.
Okay.
For so funds, for this destroying and damages.
So this is a crisis of monumental scale. I mean, you have COVID, with that you have the lockdown, and you have to maintain social distancing. And on top of that, you have Umphan, which has come and devastated the place. You have Ganga, which has breached its banks, as you mentioned. Now, so it is quite difficult to imagine. Now, Maitreyi and Pankaj and Adarsh, if you can explain how you have set up this whole management of, you know, what you're doing, because you're reaching out to 200-300 odd families, and how big is your team, and how you're, if you have divided student teams, how is it? It would be very nice to know how you've gone about doing this.
Adarsh, would you like to?
Would you mind if I speak in Hindi?
Hindi is okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah. So, हम लोग को जब पता चला कि the condition is like that, कि हम लोग contact किए जो बच्चे आते थे हम लोग के पास पढ़ने के लिए, तो उनके कंडीशंस के बारे में एक बच्चे के बारे में पता चला कि उसे इसी अम्फन और कोविड में, चूंकि उनके पेरेंट्स लोग जॉब लॉस्ट हो गया था उनका, तो ही हैड टू गो टू सेल वेजिटेबल्स नियर बाय इन दैट कंडीशन. तो देन वी थॉट कि नहीं, द सिचुएशन इज more critical as we are imagining. So we started, we form a team. हम लोग ने एक टीम बनाई, जितने लोग थे हम लोग के, like volunteers, जो जितने भी college के students, सब लोगों ने मिल के There we distributed the phone numbers of each of the parents, and then distribute for each phone number we distributed the volunteers for them, and then they call उन लोगों ने call करा, फिर उनके conditions के बारे में पता करा कि कैसे हैं वो लोग, क्या चाहिए उन लोग को और आसपास कैसा चल रहा है उस हिसाब से. तो फिर सब कुछ एक्सेस करने के बाद, कंडीशंस एक्सेस करने के बाद, हम लोगों ने अलग अलग ये फंड्स रेज करने का आइडिया है कि फॉर हेल्पिंग देम वी कैन ओनली वे टू हेल्प देम इज टू प्रोवाइड देम विथ मनी बिकॉज मेन रीजन वाज दैट दे हैव लॉस्ट देयर जॉब्स. एंड तो हम लोगों ने टीम बनाई. तो फिर उसमें अलग अलग डिविजन्स हुए, जैसे वी फॉर्म अ टीम फॉर सर्वेइंग, वी फॉर्म अ टीम फॉर सोशल मीडिया इंटरेक्शंस लाइक शेयरिंग आवर पोस्टर्स एंड अनदर थिंग्स, एंड देन द टीम फॉर कलेक्टिंग फंड्स एंड देन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द फंड्स. देन व्हेन वी कैन, तो इस आफ्टर टू और थ्री डेज we collected the amount for our first phase distribution. Then we started distributing the funds. Fir uske baad hum log confirm kar we asked them, we confirm, then the same volunteers called them, called the family and confirmed that whether they have received money, and we tell them to buy the rations, and they send photos to us with while buying ration and using them, and that, in that way we confirm that the money has reached to them. And for the second phase, the same procedure we started, and it's going on.
Yeah, I would like to add something to others. So Mr. Shin, frankly speaking, we never thought of like we will go this far initially, like after just during COVID, like we were not thinking only. So after COVID, this Ampan happened, and I was talking to Maitri once ki Bengal mein kaisa situation hai tu batao. To wo boli bhaiya aisa situation hai hamara ghar ke aas paas aisa ho gaya, there are destruction everywhere means everywhere in Bengal. So maine bola Maitri ko, bacche log kaise hain, wo log to pehle bhi COVID se affected the, ab kya hoga pata nahi, un logo ko khana mil raha hai ki nahi basic, we should at least ask them like what is the situation right now. So with that we started. So हमारा पहला ऑब्जेक्टिव था कि बच्चों को कवर करना विद द बेसिक फूड. हम लोग ने सोचा नहीं था कि वी विल गो विद दिस फंड थिंग लेटर ऑन. सो वी टॉक टू स्टूडेंट्स देयर एंड वी फाउंड लाइक सिचुएशन बहुत ही गंभीर है, मीनिंग खाना नहीं है, उनका घर में डिस्ट्रक्शन हुआ है एंड मेनी थिंग्स. सो इनिशियली वी स्टार्टेड for like we started asking people, those who we know, like contribute, and we will try to help our students. So pehla phase mein we got a very wonderful response, like we estimated something like around x amount and we got y amount, and y is very very greater than x. So we completed our first phase of distribution and we thought let's help others as well jo wahan pe affected hai. But the problem is we didn't know that we can't go there. That was the major problem. And thing is ki we started getting calls from many family members saying they are running into crisis and they need money immediately, but we can't provide money without verification, since like though they are in a dire need of money, we just can't give money. That was like we discussed. So finally humne wahan ke jo students the ek do, unka help liya. We ask them to conduct the survey and provide us the data. So till yesterday they themselves have conducted the surveys and provided us the data. But in beech mein hamari baat wahan ke localites se hui, meaning we had a talk with one of the local neta there as well. And initially it sounds convincing, like the way he told, like they are helping people with the things and they can help us as well if we carry out such things, survey there. But later we found out like that is not the case. He is only helping those whom ही नोज पर्सनली. सो लाइक हमसे फोन में बात हुई थी, उन्होंने बोला था कि हम सबकी हेल्प नहीं करेंगे पंकज, वी विल गिव यू द डेटा, हम उन्हीं को हेल्प करेंगे. बट लेटर वी डिसाइडेड नॉट टू गो विद दैट अप्रोच. इट सीम्स somehow biased to us, like to help one people and to not to help other people without knowing their background. So yeah, I agree. It was not easy for us at all to do all this management. So finally, we are thinking to serve all the people in that area, whether they are affected or not affected, with the basic Rasan kits. So we had a lot of plan, Mr. Sen, like how to distribute, what to distribute, and what would be the quantity, keeping in mind the family size and all. It was a challenge and it was a learning as well for us.
Yeah, definitely it's going to be a huge challenge. Pankaj, you mentioned 2-3 things. Ek to aapne bataya ki you are not able to reach the place. That's number one.
Yes. Yes.
Why was that?
Due to we have few students like from our college who are involved in ICHE and who are very keen towards ICHE, who can do work. But due to COVID, they are all home and nobody's in college or nearby area. That is the one challenge that we are facing. So we are running short of human resources, kind of.
Yeah. So how many people are there?
If I could just add in.
Sure.
Even I am in Kolkata. I really want to go there, but the roads have just opened on 1st June. So we couldn't go there earlier. There were all barricades in the Kolkata roads, the polices with requirement of e-passes, and the roads destroyed because of trees. So the clearing is still on, but yeah, we have the permission to go now. So yeah.
Yeah, okay. So accessibility is a big problem. Even though if you have the resources, you cannot reach it to the people. That's a problem.
Yes.
And yes. How are you doing the coordination? You, Pankaj, you talked about 3-4 different types of teams. So one team is doing the collection. One team is contacting the parents of your students in ICHE. You have so many different types of teams. How's the coordination being done?
So in the first phase, we just got the band detail of those for 37 families and distributed. And so that was the first phase. The second phase, like I said, there's one student named Rakesh. He's helping us with the data. So what we did, we have provided him the sets of data that he needs to collect, meaning he will go and he'll ask people like, do you have a ration card? Yes or no? Are you running short of food? If yes, what kind of food? Or If not, what is your intake? What are you having on a daily basis? Then so few parameters and few variables we have provided to Rakesh and he's providing us the data. So that's how we got the data. Secondly, what to give and how to give. So we have this ICHE team, we discussed on phone, we have this many amount collected and these are the families affected, so how to provide. So we have decided we'll go with this amount of rice, with this amount of atta and all. Now distribution phase, there we have to be present manually. So this Matri came up with a great idea, there should not be a duplicate, means same family should not receive the benefit twice. I guess Matri can tell you the Matri.
Yes. So what we were thinking of is that one day priorly, we'll go to that place. And as we already have the data of the families, we can talk to them just like Rakesh talked to them previously without any mention of anything great happening. And just after talking, we can provide a coupon which will have a number on it, a serial number. And we'll take one of their unique IDs. That could be Aadhaar card number, that could be PAN card number, some sort of unique information from them. And only then we will say that keep this coupon safely so that you can receive ration from this. So during the distribution, it will be easier because even if someone has duplicated the coupon, he or she will not have the unique ID of the other family. So we'll have that data and we'll verify and only then we'll give. So that will prevent duplication. Also, the families that are there in the list will ensure that each of them gets it.
Okay. So you have already implemented this process?
No. Coupon distribution, actually, we just today finalized that we'll have to give to 226 families. Till morning, it was 200. So we are thinking before distribution will go, but we haven't gone yet. And also the team that will go, there are some minor decision making to be left, who will go and when to go, because one person can't do the thing in a day. So all these, also we'll have to take safety precautions and buy necessary equipments and all those things.
Yeah, that is also very important because you have COVID. So you have to get your PPEs and, you know, the face masks and everything. How many people are there in the team?
So I am in the survey team. So my team has 12 people now. I think there are 4 people in distribution and collection team. In social media, I guess it is 8 to 10. I'm not too sure. But yeah, that's a number.
And do you have a central team which is coordinating all, or how does that happen?
So basically today everyone is working to WhatsApp. So there is a central WhatsApp group where each of us is added, and every important announcement is posted there. So if anyone has to have an announcement, he will post it there. For small announcements, like if I have to make a survey announcement or something like that, that will be posted in a survey team. There is a decision-making team as well, because first years, they are newcomers. So we'll still have to decide who is a better decision maker, and we'll have to see some qualities. So what we have been doing since Pankaj Bhaiya's time was Pankaj Bhaiya used to take second, third and fourth years into a group and for the decision making. So the same continues. We have a core team of Itche that is always there, irrespective of COVID, irrespective of Umphun, that is always there for the working of Itche. So decision making is sometimes done in that core group, sometimes done with every one of us. It depends. It really depends.
Okay. So thank you very much. Could you share with the audience the extent of damage, if you have any idea? From Rakesh or whoever has been there, who has seen it, and you know, who have actually got some sort of a report, the extent of damage in the area that's in the Shippur area, between your college boundary wall and the Ganga.
So I have not really analyzed the data that Rakesh has given for the food damage part. But he has sent me around maybe 25 to 30 photos of destruction. Destruction varies from one of the walls partially broken to the entire ceiling gone. So I think there are at least 30 to 40 houses which are affected. But Mr. Zain, again, I cannot give you the exact number. They are doing restoration on their part as much as they can do. The things that have flown away, they are going to fetch it from somewhere. Even the local parties seems that have been giving those flexes or sheets to cover the ceilings for the time being. But Mr. Singh, I cannot give you the exact number of the destruction.
Yeah, because once you get there, then only you get to understand how deep is the trouble. And so at this point, Aditya, you've been quiet for a long time. So maybe you want to throw in a few words.
And thank you so much for enabling such a discussion where we could almost cover all the points. I was recently reading a news piece where it says that Cyclone Umphun has caused loss estimated at about $13 billion in India. And, you know, there's a certain amount of loss in Bangladesh as well, I heard. So there's a huge loss. And what we can do in our small capacity is to, you know, build our state, our country bit by bit. And I think this is what the effort these guys are putting towards. So guys, again, I think, you know, if we could give you the donation details, and Prakya, if you could show it on the screen and let me know, you know, when it is shown up on the screen. Thank you so much, Prakya. So, guys, what you're seeing on the screen are bank details and UPI IDs of the two volunteers who are actively working towards this relief fund and its usage. So, ICHE is a student outreach society at IIST Shibpur, which teaches the students from the slum areas nearby IIST Shibpur. And in this crisis of Umphun and COVID-19, when Bengal has been extremely challenged by these two situations, these guys are working very hard to elevate bit by bit the status and the future of our families in India and in Bengal especially. So guys, do check out, UPI IDs are given of Deependra Pushkar and Asif Iftikhar, both are students of the very same college and the very same student outreach initiative. The account numbers and IFSC codes are given. We'll be sharing all the reports and the, you know, photos from the groundwork being done. So you don't need to worry about accountability. But please do donate. Every donation counts. It can be small, it can be big, does not matter. It really counts. So whatever you can do in your small capacity, in your big capacity, please do that. And it would be really helpful for all of us. I think, you know, as humanity, I won't even say as, you know, Bengal or as India, as humanity, that we come together in this crisis time and show some unity, at least in this time. And this is what the topic is for today. We were, you know, discussing it for a while. We did not call out the topic loud, which was tackling a crisis. And we are in the midst of two right now. And we have tackled many a crisis in the past and we have come out of it as a human race and we have evolved much better. So I think this crisis will also help us learn a lot. And as we have discussed in the past podcasts, unlearn, relearn, and adapt. But yeah, for that, I think all of us need to work extra hard. All of us need to, you know, do something out of our own comfort zone. So please do definitely donate, guys. It would, each contribution would really go a long way in helping all the families whom ICHE is helping. And it is an initiative which has been praised by the government also, recently been tweeted by Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, who is our minister of our HRD. So guys, definitely please do donate. And yeah, Pragya, you can probably remove it from the screen. And guys, we'll be posting it in the comments also. I'll be posting it again. So please do that. And yeah, coming to the topic of today, you know, which was tackling a crisis. Guys, one thing which I definitely want to ask you all is, and I want all of you to give your opinions. So Pankaj is an IT engineer. Maitre is a CS engineer, right? You guys are all engineers, basically. So now, how did this, you know, willingness to do some social work or this initial instinct to go out of your way and contribute to the society strike you? Like, ye pehle kaha se inspiration mila ye kaam karne ko, ichhe set up karne ko, and ye Umphun ke time pe apna sab kaam ko side mein rakke, apne kaam से थोड़ा टाइम निकाल के इस इनिशिएटिव में देने को ये इंस्पिरेशन कहाँ से आया आप लोगों को? इफ आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट विद पंकज.
या थैंक्स आदित्य. सो या लाइक आई सेड ICHE इज ऑल स्टार्टेड लाइक बैक विद द मेन मोटिव टू प्रोवाइड सम क्वालिटी एजुकेशन इन आवर फ्री टाइम. मीनिंग वी एज अ स्टूडेंट हैव अ लॉट ऑफ फ्री टाइम एंड the only way as a student we can give back the society something is by providing education to someone who is not privileged enough to get some. So that's how we started. So the main objective of ICHE was to teach the society or teach the people how we can run as a single entity, meaning we started in our college and same we are like encouraging other students in other colleges to do the same in their areas. So in this way, you know, India is such a big country with such a large background of people, meaning you have a very rich people, you have a very poor people, you have a middle class people, and in that middle class there are a lot of variants. So we strongly believe like government can't do everything by themselves. We as a people do owe something to the country. Those who are like privileged enough to get basic good education do owe the country to provide education back to the other people of the country. So with that motive, we started. The agenda of this relief camp or this fund camp is very similar. we are not asking every people to donate to this cause only. Rather, what we are asking people means what the hidden message is, whomever you know, and if they are affected, help them in whatever you want, like in whatever way you can, just help them. This is a crisis time, and this is a time where we as a human being needs to come as a single entity. And this is really a tough exam time. Like I must say, this is a like exam time. If we pass, we'll come out as more stronger than ever. So whomever you know, and they are in need, help them in your area. So if each of one of us are helping even a single person, I think we'll be good to go. We'll be able to tackle this crisis as well in a very good way. And yeah, so that's
thank
all.
You so much, Pankaj. I think it's really inspiring. आदर्श, तुम्हारा कैसे मन किया इस इनिशिएटिव में आने का? बिकॉज़ कॉलेज में पढ़ रहे हो अभी, तो आई थिंक छुट्टियां एंजॉय करने का भी टाइम है, बट हाउ डिड यू फील कि मेरे को इस सोशल इनिशिएटिव में कंट्रीब्यूट करना चाहिए या मेरे को खुद से एक स्टेप लेना चाहिए? मेहनत काफी लग रही होगी, सो वेयर डिड दिस इंस्पिरेशन कम फ्रॉम?
हां भैया, तो मेरे लिए ये था कि कॉलेज में छुट्टियां हो गई थी, मैं यहां पे घर पे था, तो दैट कॉल फ्रॉम दैट कॉल फ्रॉम दैट किड, जब हम लोग को पता चला उस बच्चे के बारे में कि ही हैज टू गो टू सेल वेजिटेबल्स, एंड आई मैं खुद भी गांव में रहता हूँ, तो आसपास में ये दिखता है कि कैसे लोग स्ट्रगल करते हैं जनरली बिहार में. तो जनरली आई एम फ्रॉम बिहार, तो बाढ़ वगैरह जब भी आता है तो आसपास की जगहों पर दिखता है कि इन दोज टाइम्स पीपल स्ट्रगल्स लॉट. तो उस हिसाब से लगा कि हाँ, उन लोग की भी मदद करनी चाहिए. आज ठीक है, हम लोग की छुट्टी हो गई, घर पे है, बट दे ऑल्सो डिजर्व समथिंग लाइक दैट, वी कैन हेल्प देम इस हिसाब से. और वैसे भी अब 2 साल लगभग हो गया उन लोग के साथ, तो देयर इज एन अटैचमेंट विद देम, दैट्स हाउ द मोटिवेशन कम्स टू मी.
आई थिंक आप जुड़ने लग जाओ तो एक बार स्टूडेंट से या फिर जिसकी भी आप साथ काम कर रहे हो, तो फिर वो मतलब उनकी हर प्रॉब्लम अपनी लगने लगती है, उनकी हर सक्सेस भी अपनी लगने लगती है.
और लाइक बहुत ही इंस्पिरेशनल वी हैव अच्छे क्लासेस आफ्टर आवर क्लासेस इन द कॉलेज. तो क्लास में जो भी हो, लैब में जो भी हो, लाइक जब भी आप वहां जाए तो देयर इज अनदर एनवायरनमेंट, मतलब सब कुछ बिल्कुल अलग सरग, जो भी टेंशन सब कुछ दूर हो जाता है. लाइक मेरे लिए एक गिव एंड टेक प्रोसेस है, वहाँ बच्चे भी सीखते हैं, हम लोग को भी बच्चों से सीखने को मिलता है वहाँ पे डेफिनेटली. तो मोटिवेशन वाज दैट.
थैंक यू सो मच आदर्श, आई थिंक ये बहुत ही इंस्पिरेशनल है और हम सबके लिए एक बहुत बड़ा मैसेज है. आई वुड लाइक टू हियर टू मैत्री. And before that, I would like to comment ki friends, everyone of you know, every member of ICCHE is either an engineer or studying some program in IIST Shippur, and IIST Shippur does not offer a BA in education. IIST Shippur does not offer a BEd. It's a very prestigious engineering and MBA college. Engineering is the most like, you know, popular course of its. So development sector ke courses wahan pe hain nahi, lekin जरूरी नहीं है. मतलब मेरा जो पॉइंट है, यू नो, इज दैट डेवलपमेंट सेक्टर में होना या फिर बीए इन एडुकेशन या फिर बीएड या फिर बीएसडब्ल्यू बैचलर ऑफ सोशल वर्क करना ही जरूरी नहीं है सोशल वर्क के लिए. आई थिंक अगर दिमाग में इम्पैक्ट का एक माइंडसेट है, तो वो फिर आपने कोई सी भी डिग्री करी हो, किसी भी फील्ड में आप हो, आप डेफिनेटली सोशल इम्पैक्ट ड्रिवन वर्क करोगे अपने काम के जरिए भी, जो आपका करियर है. एंड if you want to pick up some project which you want to volunteer for, that will also add a lot to your career. Ye ek cheez bhi I think I wanted to add. So yeah, Maitri, how did you get the inspiration to work with the students with ICCHE? And you've said that since the day you were in college, you were in ICCHE. So kyun man kiya is club ka hissa banne ke liye aur social work karne ke liye when you were already an engineer?
So bhaiya, it started with two seniors of mine, two didis who came to our hostel ki aisa ICCHE karke club hai और ऐसे पढ़ाया जाता है गरीब बच्चों को, तो आप ज्वाइन करना चाहते हो कि नहीं. तो इनिशियली डर था, सीनियर्स रैगिंग होगा, फर्स्ट ईयर फर्स्ट मंथ ऑफ माय कॉलेज, फिर पेरेंट्स का वो था कि पेरेंट्स ने भेजा है कॉलेज से पढ़ने के लिए, पढ़ाई करना होगा, तो डर था. तो मैं गई फर्स्ट डे निच्छे में, पंकज भैया थे, स्प्रीति दी थी, कुछ सीनियर्स थे, और उनसे इंटरेक्शन करके कभी लगा ही नहीं कि सीनियर्स हैं, लगता था कि खुद के भैया दीदी हैं. और मैं अकेली बच्ची हूँ, पैम्पर्ड हूँ, फर्स्ट टाइम घर छोड़ के गई थी, तो काफ़ी टाइम ऐसा डिप्रेशन लगता था, बुरा लगता था, रोना लगता था. बट फर्स्ट ईयर में हार्डली कोई क्लासेस होगी कि मैं नहीं गई होंगी, क्योंकि हमेशा भैया जाती थी. देर वॉज ओनली थिंग दैट आई गॉट इन रिटर्न, दैट वॉज हैप्पीनेस. हंसती थी, खुश रहती थी, अच्छा लगता था उनके साथ. फर्स्ट ईयर ऐसे गया मेरा कि बहुत हंसी मजाक इनके साथ. फिर सेकेंड ईयर में वही कंटिन्यू किया, फिर वो अटैचमेंट बन गया. भैया ऐसा नहीं है कि मैं सारे बच्चों का नाम जानती हूँ वहाँ पे, नहीं जानती मैं, बट वो जिनको मैं देखती हूँ ना, तो लगता है कि नहीं मुझे इनके साथ रहना है. और चारों साल हमने उसके साथ, उनके साथ, चाहे दिवाली हो, होली हो, रिपब्लिक डे हो, पिकनिक करना हो, सब किया है भैया इनके साथ. तो मतलब 4 years बाद ऐसे बहुत बुरा ही लग रहा था कि विल गो, विल मिस देम, बट ये सब हो गया, कोविड एंड उम्फुन ये सब पता चला. तो फिर जैसे भैया आदर्श ने बोला है, जिनके लिए हम फील करते हैं उनको कुछ होता है तो हमें ही दिक्कत होती है. और देर वेर पीपल, देर वेर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जिनसे हम फंड ले सकते थे, बट वी नेवर आस्क्ड फॉर दैट, एंड दैट्स बिकॉज वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू कलेक्ट फंड ईजिली. We want to collect funds such that it reaches more people. मतलब हमने किसी NGO से ले लिया या हमने किसी ऐसे organization से ले लिया, हमारे लिए तो easily collect हो गया, हमारा मकसद reach हो गया. But had that money been used by them, they would have reached more masses. So that is also a message that I would like to give out. ज़रूरी नहीं है कि आप हमें ही दें, but आप जिनको भी दें वो reach करें जिनको चाहिए उनके लिए. हम कर लेंगे कोशिश, हम और रास्ते अपना लेंगे, हम बहुत मुश्किलें झेलेंगे, बट हम लोग भी हेल्प करेंगे, आप लोग भी करिए. वेस्ट बंगाल में आज दिक्कत है, मुंबई में आज साइक्लोन आया है, एमपी, महाराष्ट्र में लोकस प्रॉब्लम है, इंडिया में हर जगह कुछ ना कुछ हो रहा है. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि अपॉर्चुनिटीज नहीं है, मुझे दिखा नहीं कि कुछ दिक्कतें हैं, दिक्कतें हर जगह है, आपको बस वो नजरिया होना चाहिए, आप देख सको, उनको हेल्प कर सको. और आपका कुछ नहीं जाएगा, थोड़ा एफर्ट, थोड़ा टाइम, बट आपको जितना सुकून मिलता है ना, वो बहुत ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है. दैट्स ऑल भैया.
दैट्स वेरी वेल सेड.
थैंक यू.
इट्स वेरी वेल सेड, एंड आई थिंक अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू पुट अ पिन ऑन इज दैट सेंस ऑफ फुलफिलमेंट. तो वो जो एक संतुष्टि होती है, एक सैटिस्फैक्शन होती है, वो कोई प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करने से ही आती है. And I think, you know, when we teach entrepreneurship to students also, तब भी हम यही बात करते हैं कि समाज की कोई ऐसी समस्या देखो जो आपको लगता है कि इसका समाधान करने से बहुत सारी जिंदगियां बेहतर हो जाएंगी. तो आई थिंक एवरी बिजनेस, एवरी एनजीओ, एवरी सोसाइटी इज ड्रिवन बाय दैट मेंटालिटी ओनली. यू नो, एवरी गुड सोसाइटी, आई वुड से एवरी गुड बिजनेस, बाकी तो बहुत सारे है इस दुनिया में बिजनेसेस एंड एनजीओस, बट आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ द गुड एनजीओस बिजनेसेस आर ड्रिवन बाय दिस मेंटालिटी, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे आर मच रिस्पेक्टेड एंड revered in the society. And Ichche, I think, is one of the best societies I have ever seen, you know, as a college society, which there's almost, I would not even say almost, which is an NGO in its own right, almost. Like, you know, jo ek development sector ka bahut bada pillar hai, I see Ichche as that, literally. Because the amount of effort that has been put into it and the amount of impact that has been achieved already, it's a very young initiative. It's like, I'm pretty sure it's not older than 5-6 years. So, us hisab se, you know, the amount of impact you guys have achieved is amazing. Or, Mr. Sen, I would like to ask one final question before maybe, you know, showing the details again on the screen and closing the podcast. What do you think is the philosophy behind social work? So, you know, I obviously mentioned about it not being always a part of the development sector. But, you know, how does it help in your career, or how does it contribute to your personality development? I would like to talk about that. Because we always think that we have to give something. We are giving. We are the, you know, bigger persons. We are the bigger people. But is it that? Do we not gain anything out of social work? That's my question to you.
Okay, that's a very interesting question. So let me try, and I'll go back to what a renowned anthropologist said. She was from the West. Her name was Margaret Mead. So she was asked in a class like you did just now to me as to what she considered to be the turning point in civilization and humanity of the human race. And everybody expected her to say when the pottery was invented, when fire was invented, or when, you know, all these other things, when the Iron Age came and so on and so forth. But you know what she said? She replied by saying that when a femur bone, that is the bone that attaches your hip to your knee, has been broken and healed, that is the first sign of civilization and humanity. Now, what she meant was, in those days, 10,000, 15,000 years ago, if someone could not walk, that someone died. Because they could not run, they could not get, so they could not run away from predators who could come and attack them. They could not go and look for food because they could not move. But when that bone is healed, it means someone else took care of them for the 6 weeks or so it takes for the bone to heal. And that was the start of civilization and humanity. So today, what Ichhe is doing is carrying forward that age-old humanity spirit that defines a person, a human being, through their work. And I think that feeling of helping someone else who's in need so that someone can recover, stand up on their feet, and then do everything again is the true definition of being civilized and being human.
That's a wonderful way to explain it, Mr. Sain. And I think, you know, the one thing we can draw from this is when you do social work, and not just social work, when you do anything which is beneficial to the society and which is inclusive in nature, something like, you know, where we are trying to help the victims of a particular cyclone which we had no control over in coming up to the same level at which they were, and they need the help of humanity, which in the future they can also help through their efforts once, you know, if in case we face something like this. So I think the whole humanity helps each other, they come together and they make progress. That's what evolution is. So social work or any help to the society where we include more people into the whole ecosystem ensures evolution. And
absolutely right. And when we are serving other people, I think that is when we are at our best. And that's the time when we are the happiest.
Absolutely. So guys, thank you so much for watching the stream. And I'll do one last kind of, you know, display on the screen of the photo. So Pragya, if you can display the photo on the screen and we can talk about it a bit. And if you can let me know once it is displayed. Great. So thank you so much, Pragya. I think it is on the screen, guys. So you can right now see the bank details of two individuals who are working with the voluntary team of Ichhe. And they are completely committed to the cause. So you can see their bank details, their UPI IDs on the screen. So I'll put in two requests. One is that if you have liked the podcast till the 71st episode, any episode, if you have liked it or you have learned something from it, those who are watching live, those who are watching the recorded version, please definitely do donate whatever your capacity is. No contribution is small. So please do donate. Phase two of the relief work is being carried out by Ichhe. They have already conducted the phase one successfully and have gotten appreciation from the highest of high chairs from the government of India. So this is great relief work happening, guys, and this is the humanity coming together. So please do become a part of this revolution and definitely do donate. The other details, you know, if you don't find it on the screen sometime, you'll definitely find it in the comments. I have commented through my own Facebook ID, which is Aditya Bose. You can see it in the comment section. I have put in two comments with the link. So you can go to the link. The photo is posted there. by watching the photo, you'll get all the bank details. Do definitely donate. So Pragya, you can take off the photo from the screen now. Great. So thank you so much, guys. First of all, I would like to thank Maitri, Adarsh, and Pankaj. बहुत short notice पे हमने सबको you know ये podcast के बारे में intimate किया कि that today we'll start a donation drive till our 75th podcast. Thank you so much to my team, Pragya, Ankita, and Vinayak for quickly you know making it come together. Thank you so much, Mr. Sain. And thank you so much to the audience for watching. And I know a lot of you have watched, so now please do definitely donate. हमें अगर वो number bank में दिखे और वो bank में number जो है वो जब लोगों तक पहुंचे उसकी photo दिखे तो बहुत अच्छा लगेगा हमें. So definitely please do donate. और I'll also be running like you know the next 2-3 podcasts we'll be running will be donation drive related podcast. So we'll pick no sponsorships. तो जो भी अगर आपको लगे contribute आप कर सकते हैं please do donate and it will be amazing. आज का पॉडकास्ट गाइस थोड़ा अनप्लान्ड था, सो यू माइट हैव नोटिस्ड अ फ्यू ग्लिचेस हियर एंड देयर कि कभी स्क्रीन पे फोटो थोड़ा लंबे टाइम के लिए हुआ, कभी मे बी यू नो समबडी वाज म्यूटेड एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स. सो थोड़ा प्लानिंग हमने उतना कर नहीं पाए थे आज से पहले, सो डू फॉरगिव अस इफ द क्वालिटी ऑफ द स्ट्रीम वॉज नॉट एज गुड एज इट इज यूजली, बट आई थिंक अभी प्लानिंग से ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है एग्जीक्यूशन एंड It's a crisis time as we were discussing as the topic today. So it's crisis time. So execution is very important and quick execution is very important, which these guys are doing. And we definitely should, must help them out. So guys, with this, I think we'll put an end to today's podcast. Do watch its recorded version. Do donate and do encourage your friends, family members, distant ones, close ones, everyone to donate. I think it will go a long way. With this, thank you so much for coming to the podcast. Stay home, stay safe. If nothing is urgent, please go out. If it is urgent work only, then go out because the number of COVID cases is still increasing in India and it is still a spot of bother. So stay home as much as possible. Wash your hands and take care of yourself and your family. We'll see you tomorrow at the same time, 6 p.m. live on Facebook. Please like the page of Ichhe to follow more of their amazing work with the students, with their families. And please do like Pro Bono. And follow our post notifications for getting more updates related to the stream and related to everything else that we are doing. Take care and bye-bye.